Do you want to see a unique experiment with a standard technology for a blackout or even for off-grid living? The gasoline generator is in one of every 10 households. Would I tell you how to get 3 times more energy from the fuel? That makes the fossil fuel less damaging for the environment, and the blackout will be less expensive for you. Hello, energy explorers. Welcome back to the channel. I'm Norbert, energy engineer. In today's video 78, I update you on an exciting new progress. This week, on my micro combined heat and power system for home. This system not only generates electricity, but also utilizes the waste heat for home heating, a practical and energy efficient solution for a cold winter. And now I really applied it, blowing away any doubt about the practical value of this unusual solution.
Unbelievable!
I really didn't find any example on YouTube of using both electricity and the heat from the well-known gasoline generator. And yet, 2/3 of the chemical energy in the fuel is usually discarded as heat. So I have a good solution for cold regions, especially because the gasoline generator is the hero in emergency situations. Not only in areas without infrastructure, but especially in wars and also in developed countries, where often the capacity of the grid is at its limit. A mind-blowing trick that is seldom mentioned is a full and efficient exploitation of the generator at a nominal power by storing the electricity into a battery so that you can consume it in silence in the hours afterwards. That is in contrast with the usual way of using this generator, by running it continuously, also when there's little consumption. You see that also on the Christmas market. Expensive gasoline generators with an inverter will slow down automatically when there's little consumption, but it will still be inefficient if you have only a few LED lamps, a computer and a fridge running on it. This battery trick for silent power supply is already a huge benefit for the rational use of the fuel, and it saves the nerves of your neighbors. Strange that it is applied so rarely. However, the big satisfaction is that today I tapped for the first time into the 2/3 that is always discarded as exhaust heat. In the previous videos that are in the dedicated video playlist on micro CHP, you saw that I lead the gases, the exhaust gases, into a radiator. Now, after only 10 minutes of runtime under about 50% of load on the generator, this small second-hand heavy radiator of about 40 kilograms was already at 45 degrees Celsius and very uniform also, I may say. So today I was using 1/3 of the fuel's energy for electricity and another 1/3 from the heat in the exhaust gas. What is lacking is to use the last 1/3 of the total chemical energy. That is in the hot engine, especially the cylinder and also the muffler, which is getting really hot. Those calories are hard to capture because they are all inside this furious noise source that you want to keep far from your living space. Water-cooled generators would be able to deliver this heat as warm water that you can lead to your living space through the walls, but they are typically 10 times as expensive as a standard air-cooled generator, also because they are too big for the typical consumptions of a household. I discussed interesting solutions for this motor for the engine heat already 2 videos ago, in number 76, but we'll test this in another video. Now let's see what I did in the experiment and then suggest how to make it more practical for your home. But first, I want to invite you to help the climate and also yourself by taking control of your energy situation and not be a simple subject of the big players of the energy world. They certainly do a good job, and we have much more access to energy than 50 years ago. However, the nowadays strong tendency to shift our energy use from fuel to electricity is difficult to follow by the electrical infrastructure. And they have also a hard time to survive because of the price wars on the free market. How do you think that they can give their undivided attention to you, small consumer, when something triggers the avalanche of a big blackout? From a quick research, it seems that a surprising factor of 10% of households in developed countries have a generator running on fuel. In developing countries, it will be more. If you are an owner of such a generator, then you are well on your way to make a better use of it and step into the two-thirds of wasted energy. You will also be in a better situation if something happens. I hope that you appreciate this video series. To miss nothing, you can subscribe. That will help me to create other videos about CHP or combined heat and power that is already widely applied in industry. And of course, I will also create videos about other subjects. And you know, it will always be about sustainable energy or security of supply. And security of supply is SOS in English. Even if I'm talking in the CHP series about fossil fuel, at least I help you to avoid wasting those two-thirds of the energy in the fuel that is always discarded by others. Let's dive now into the details of the experiments. Afterwards, I will explain how you can apply it in a practical way for your home. So let's now see how we can realize this in a real-world situation in your house. The generator shall stay in a room where the noise of the generator doesn't hinder much, for example in a garage, but not outside, as we saw already in video 76, because then a good part of the heat is really lost. Don't worry, in the following videos we will see how we will make this generator more silent. The exhaust gas must be let into the radiator, and this shall be installed in the living space, but without chance of leakage, because that is dangerous. Buy a CO alarm, coal monoxide, because that is not expensive and it is important. However, like with normal radiators, why should this radiator leak? They are installed in each house, and with this CO alarm, it's easier to find a gas leak than normally a water leak. In order to make holes in the ceiling and in the wall with a minimum diameter, use 1/2-inch metal tubes and clenching fittings, like I used in video 71 in Sicily, because with the tubes with an own nut, then you need a bigger hole. From the radiator, the gases can go outside. Take care of regulations, but consider also that the small motorbike has already much more exhaust gases than this generator. That is also the reason that I advise to run it for a few hours at nominal power and store the electricity in a battery, so that you need to run it only for a few hours a day, so therefore also less hours of emissions. So next week I will experiment with solutions to recover the last one-third of the energy, of the chemical energy. Watch video 76 where I mentioned these solutions and tell me which solution for the recovery of the energy, the engine heat, you like the most. Put it on the in the comments into that video 76 or this video here, so that I can take it into account. So have a nice weekend and I wish you good energy.